Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the Cubic Spiral Burr. Cubic Spiral Burr is an idea that I have been playing with already since the 1990s. So this is what the cubic spiral burr or a cubic spiral looks like. It's just cubes that go on top of each other unit by unit. And one of the interesting things about this shape is that it fits so nicely through each other. So my idea was, can I build this into a nice shape? And the obvious shape to build from this is, of course, the cubic spiral burr, where you have a total of 12 pieces and they all go diagonally through the cube. However, one problem is there that once it fits together, the pieces don't come apart. At least not if the pieces were rigid. And here comes the magic. These pieces are not rigid, they're flexible. They are made of TPE material and you can flex them. And actually I've done a lot of experiments with different materials and gluing techniques and printing techniques, including a lot of failures. This is another material that's even more flexible. And I bought a spool of this material, and it's now the puzzle is solvable. And don't be scared. You can just flex the pieces and flex even more. And here we have a first piece out. And then once you have the first one out, it's not too difficult to get more pieces out. And then gradually the puzzle comes apart. The making of these pieces was quite difficult because this flexible material, it was not possible to print these pieces with support material. So I tried in different orientations like this or like this, and somehow it didn't work. So I had to glue, but I couldn't find any glue that worked. So my final trick has been printing these pieces in three parts and then having holes in there with screws. And even the holes, they have a shape. And so I put glue into the four holes, then four screws in there at the other side as well. And now the pieces are shape locked to the screws and to each other. So this is what makes a very strong and rigid glue connection. But still the piece remains sufficiently flexible to work. So after maybe 20 years after the first inception of this idea, finally we have the cubic spiral burr. That's this. And the obvious question about this puzzle is, this flexible material was ideal for this puzzle because the puzzle couldn't exist otherwise. And what other puzzles would benefit from this flexible material? Thank you for watching.